my second year students. I hope all of you are doing really great. And we know we are in the chapter called marketing. Before we can start the chapter, I wanted to do the mind map of the chapter, but the mind map is really big for the chapter. So that's the reason I thought, let me do it on a big board so that it's easy for you to see it, even if you can maximize the screen. Okay. So what are the topics to learn in this particular chapter? We are already here in product, but we would again start off from first. Now, the main importance of the mind map is so that keeping the mind map, it's easy for you to understand. When there are big chapters, it's easy for you to understand where exactly you are, right, in your notes, or how exactly you need to go about learning the chapter. So that's the reason I thought, let me do a mind map. Don't get worried in looking at the mind map, but the mind map is very simple, okay? And trust me, I always keep telling you, marketing is a very easy chapter. So we start off with what is the meaning of market, okay? All these are two markers, so please listen as I'm telling you. What is a market? What is marketing? Who is a marketer? What can be marketed? What is marketing management? All these will come for two markers. And in terms of scoring for your finals, this chapter holds 20% or 20 marks weightage. So that is the reason it's very important for you to understand what are you going to be learning in the chapter. Only then you know where you are going to get marks in this particular chapter. Depending on that, you can study. So these are all the two markers. That is, what is market, what is marketing, who is the marketer, what are marketing management, and what can be marketed. Now, coming down to the four markers, we have difference between marketing and selling. You need to write four differences between both, okay? Then you have features of marketing. You have features of marketing again for a four marker, which is very easy. Then you have functions of marketing, which usually comes for 8 marks. And it's very important for you to understand and learn that particular topic, because most of the question papers I've seen, that question is there. Okay? So I'll tell you where exactly the division of the chapter starts. So the next thing is you have marketing mix. Marketing mix refers to 4 P's of marketing. That is product, price, place, and promotion. That is the 4 P's of marketing. Okay? Now, you need to understand the question. When they ask you, what is the marketing mix? Explain the marketing mix. It usually comes as a four marker. You just need to write the meaning of product, price, place, and promotion. That is, if they ask you, explain marketing mix for 4 marks. But if they ask you, explain the elements of marketing mix. Okay? When this word called elements is there, I will circle off the word for you. When this word elements is there, elements refers to product mix, price mix, place mix, promotion mix. That is where, then from here, the division of the chapter starts. So until there, you can learn. But from here, you need to understand what is coming in where. Only then it's easy for you to learn the chapter. Okay, and please learn a mind map like you're learning an answer. Only then you know what and all comes in this particular chapter. Now, when we talk about product mix, there are 4 things that comes under product mix. That is product, branding, packaging, labeling. These are the 4 things that comes under product mix. When we talk about price mix, there is only one solid 8 marker that comes under this. That is factors affecting or determinants affecting the price, okay? Then when we talk about place, again under place you have channels, you have functions, you have the types of distribution, that's direct and indirect. When you talk about promotion, you have advertising, you have personal selling, you have sales promotion, and you have publicity. So in terms of scoring, I will tell you again, in terms of scoring, product mix is very, very important for you to learn. Entire product mix, please learn. Entire price mix, please learn. There's only one solid 8 marker you should learn. Entire promotion mix, please learn. Here, there's a 4 marker that will come, or a 2 marker that will come. So it's very important for you to understand what comes under the elements of marketing mix. Okay, so I have taken the first one, that's product mix. I have written product, branding, packaging, labeling. So I put it as capital A, B, C and D. Okay, so under product, when you will take product, you have classification of products. That's where you learn. The products are divided into consumable products, industrial products. Consumable products are further divided into durability and shopping efforts involved. And again, durability is further divided. Then shopping efforts involved is further divided. And industrial products is also again further divided into two. And again, those two are divided into three. Okay. So in this entire classification of products, learn all the meanings of the particular, let's say those terminologies like consumable products. And important thing is features, everything is all features. Like example, you have features of industrial products, you have features of convenience products, you have features of what other products you have, whatever features you have. Learn it for 4 marks, okay? One will come from there. So learn the, under the products, you will learn features of all these, okay? And the meanings. Now the second thing that comes under product mix is branding, okay? So branding is here written as B. Here you have what is the advantages of branding to marketer. That means what is the advantage, and that will be the next topic I'm going to teach you. So what is the advantage of branding to the marketer will come as a 4 marker. What is the advantage of branding to the consumer, 4 marker. Both put together will come as an 8 marker. What is the features of a good branding, this also usually comes 4 marker. So please learn everything below branding. Branding comes under product mix. Okay, I'm sure you're clear. So the next thing is packaging. Packaging again comes under product mix. Under packaging, you have levels of packaging. 1 level, 2 level, 3 level you have, which will come as a 2 marker. Then you have importance of packaging, which will come as a 4 marker. And the functions of packaging again for a 4 marker. So please make sure you're writing the mind maps somewhere, learning it, so that you know what comes under marketing chapter. It's easy for you to understand and learn. You can easily get 20 marks from this chapter, trust me. Okay? Then the fourth one you have is labeling. That's below product, you have labeling. Now under labeling, you have functions of a good label or functions of a label. That is the only topic that's there under labeling for a 4 marker. Now we've completed product mix. Now the second thing is price mix. Now for price, I've written it here in yellow chalk. Okay, that means it's coming under elements of marketing mix, price mix. Now I told you what is the only question you have is what are the factors affecting the pricing determination. That will come as an 8 marker. So that's the only topic, and it's a very important topic. Please ensure to learn that particular topic. Okay, so I have marked that for an 8 marker here. Now coming down to the third one, the third elements of marketing mix is place mix. Okay, place mix is also called as physical distribution. So under place mix, we have channels of distribution. Okay, this channels of distribution may come for a 4 marker, may not come, we don't know. Then we have functions of distribution channel, may come, may not come, but please go through it. Then we have types of channels, that is direct channel, indirect channel, may come, 4 marker, it usually comes. Then factors affecting the choice of channels, again go through it. So if you actually see in all these 4, this place is pretty relaxed, you can go through it. But please ensure the remaining 3, you're learning everything that comes below it. Now, promotion mix is something that's very, very important, because below promotion, you have advertising, you have personal selling, you have sales promotion, and you have publicity. Okay? Advertising has merits, has demerits, and has objections to advertising. Merits will come usually, most of the time this topic comes. Please be careful to ensure to learn the topics I'm telling you, because all the years, whatever topics I have told has come in the paper. So merits, demerits is very important for 4 marks. It will come as 8 marker. They can ask you merits for 4 marks. The remaining 4 marks, they can ask you objections. All the remaining 4 marks, they can ask you demerits of advertising. Okay? Then you have sales promotion. Under sales proportion, again you have merits, demerits. Just learn two points there because it will only come for 2 markers. That is sales promotion, merits and demerits. But you have a practical oriented question here which usually comes in the final exam. That is, what are the commonly used sales promotion tools? That question will come as a 4 marker or will come as a practical oriented question. So please learn that particular topic there. Then you have publicity. Now public relations refers to, that again is divided into 2 things. Under public relations you have, what is the role of public relations, which comes as a 4 marker. Then you have difference between public advertising and public relations for an 8 marker. Please see there, I have already marked it there. If you can see, please see, I have marked it as an 8 marker. Role of public relation is a 4 marker. Then it is again divided, you have difference between public relation and advertising for a 8 marker. So below promotion you have 4, you have advertising, you have personal selling, you have sales promotion and public relations. But personal selling, I could not write it there. So what I am going to do is, if I could write it somewhere here, can you all see? Yes, I am going to write it here so that you can see here. Okay. Okay, so under personal selling, I am going to write here, personal selling, you have, okay, you have features, you have merits and you have role of personal selling. Okay, I will write it somewhere here. You have features, you have merits and you have a role. This role of personal selling is divided into 3, okay? It's divided into importance to businessmen, importance to customers, okay? I'm writing importance to businessmen. The same thing is written customers and then society. So, if in case marks wise, this will go for an 8 marker there, okay? So, this is the mind map of the chapter. So again I will tell you, from here I will tell you. If they ask you, explain marketing mix, 4 marks you should just give the meaning of product, price, place, promotion. But if they ask you, explain the elements of marketing mix, you need to just speak general about product mix, that's write these 4, price mix, write these, place mix, write this, promotion mix, write this. For 4 marks, don't write all this story. But the subdivisions of marks and 8 marks and all starts from here. Product mix is divided into product, branding, then packaging and labeling. Product is divided into classification. Branding is divided into advantages to marketer, advantages to consumer, features of a good brand name. Then packaging is divided into levels, importance, functions. Please see the marks. Then labeling. Labeling is the 4th one under product mix. Labeling is divided into functions of a label for a 4 marker. Then you have price mix. You have one solid 8 marker and price mix. That is, what are the factors which is the determining or affecting the price determination. Then you have place mix. Under place mix, it is not very important, but there, last year there was a 4 marker which came from that particular topic where they asked you what are the different types of channels of distribution. That is direct channel and indirect channel. Again, direct channel is divided and indirect, but it's a very easy answer which you already know. Promotion mix is again divided into 4, advertising, personal selling, sales promotion and public relation. Advertising is divided into merits, demerits and objections to advertising. Sales promotion is having merits, demerits, which you learn for 2 marks, 2 points there, 2 points there on the merits, demerits. Then commonly used sales promotion tools is a 5 marker for a practical oriented question, can also come as a 4 marker. Then you have personal selling, which is there. Personal selling, you have features of personal selling, you have meaning of personal selling, merits, which you can learn again for 2 marks, and role of personal selling. What is the importance to the business? How is it important to the customer and how is it important to the society? Okay, so that again you need to learn it for 8 marks because it can come 4 plus 4. Either they can ask you business, either they can ask you customer, or either they can ask you for the society. How is personal selling useful? Personal selling is nothing but door-to-door selling. So these topics I used it. Don't get worried with the mind map. The mind map only made you so that you can stay confident, so that you know where your marks are coming from. But you should feel confident when you look at the mind map and make note of it in your books, and so that you can study the answers, not for you to leave the chapter. Okay? And the last one we have is public relations. Where we have role of public relation for a 4-marker and difference between personal selling and personal selling, public relations and advertising, which would come for a 8-marker. So this is the mind map of the entire chapter, and you have difference between personal selling and advertising. And I don't think this particular point is here. I don't think this is right. It's actually difference between personal selling and difference between personal selling and advertising for an 8-marker. So please ensure you write down the mind map somewhere very neat, and you know where you can gain your marks. Stay confident and stay positive. Thank you.